Our next guest is a Chicago girl who's making her mark on the world of indie TV. Her web series, Brown Girls, was recently nominated for an Emmy, and on top of that, the show has been picked up by HBO in a development deal. The series chronicles the lives of 20-something straight and queer women of all color, and best of all, it's set right here in Chicago. Fatimah Asghar joins us right now, the writer and creator of Brown Girls. Good morning.
Morning, how are you doing?
We're so happy to have you here. This is a series unlike any other. It has now become part of the cultural zeitgeist. It is so cool. For people who haven't heard of it yet, can you tell us about it?
Yeah, so Brown Girls is the story of Layla and Patricia, who are two best friends who are living in Chicago right after college, and basically just figuring out what it means to be young and financially independent and kind of navigating all their relationships. So it's really just a slice of life of these two girls and their complicated identities and their families and the community that they're a part of.
You're kind of part of this whole new gen hustle hard DIY moment, right?
Yes.
And Facebook and social media was a huge part of this series' success.
Mm-hmm. It totally was. I mean, for me, this was the first time I ever wrote anything for a series.
Which is crazy.
Yeah, which has been really a whirlwind. But a lot of our stuff was sourced by things like Facebook, by Twitter, by Instagram, by Tumblr. You know, our budget was like $20,000, and we crowdfunded $7,000 of that through social media and GoFundMe. And then there was always things where, even when we first started our press, like what I did was I posted a Facebook status and I was like, hey, does anyone I know want to write about our trailer? And then I had a bunch of people reach out, and it kind of became this thing where I saw it spread like wildfire on social media in a way that I was like very just taken aback by and surprised by. So there's a way that social media has been like so integral to the success of the show, and I think is often integral to the success of like web-based platforms in general.
Completely. Mm-hmm. And also integral to the show is Chicago as a city. You know, we've had more shows come to film here, like Empire, and it sort of pretends to be in Chicago because it's actually supposed to be in New York. And this show is truly Chicago. I mean, I've seen you call it a love letter to the city.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, Chicago means so much to me, and I've lived in Chicago for the last like around 6 years, and it's the place that I chose actively to be my home. I was raised in the East Coast, and it was the first place I moved after college that I was like, I think I want to be here for a while. And so there was kind of an active way that I was very much falling in love with the city. And I think the city is so incredible and unlike any other city, and often kind of gets like swept under the rug, or like you said, like it's passed off as like New York in when it's shot. And I think it's such a beautiful place to shoot. And to really get some of those wide shots that we got in Brown Girls, where you kind of zoom out and you see the colors of the city and the bus. You know, Sam Bailey, our director, was so amazing at that. And I think it's just a way of really, really wanting to say that we love the city, and the city deserves kind of to be shown in the way that we think it should.
Well, we thank you for that, because we love our city too, and we're so proud of it. So it's so cool when that's shown through art, you know?
Yeah.
So I want to read a quote that you've said before in a past interview. If I was 15, 16, whatever, and got to see these versions of myself on TV, I would have felt a lot less lonely. So this show is obviously bringing a ton of recognition and validity to people who are watching it, mm-hmm. who haven't seen representations of themselves before. Was that the catalyst for the show, or why is that so important to you?
Yeah, I mean, to me, like a lot of my friends and a lot of my friendships, I've just never seen represented in TV, right? I think often when you have women of color in TV, they're kind of at odds with each other, or they're not like fostering a kind of kindness. Whereas my whole life has been such strong relationships with women of color, and I really, really wanted to showcase that. And I think it was also this thing of just really being so insular. Like I was like, oh, the only people who are gonna watch this are my friends. Like nobody else is gonna watch it. And then it suddenly became this thing that I was like, oh, like,
hundreds of
thousands of people are watching it. And so that kind of was, I think that there was the kind of beauty in creating something that was so specific and being like, I really want to show this. And in terms of representation, you know, even at like this last Emmys, there was such amazing representation on the screen, people who won awards. But I think we have a lot of work to do, because I think that there's such nuanced stories that come from people who are often not heard, and I would love to see more TV that kind of points into that direction.
I'm glad you mentioned the Emmys because you were there this year. Can you tell us what that was like?
Yes, the Emmys was so much fun. It was really, really incredible. We went to the Creative Arts Emmys where our award was presented, and it was so, like, everybody was just so beautiful. They were decked out. The way that the whole space was decorated was amazing. And then, you know, you would just kind of see something, like, you'd be walking and Laverne Cox would walk by, and I was like, like, you know, a little bit starstruck by that. But I just think that it was such a fun time, and it was really great to be there.
And one more accolade we have to talk about is you were named the Poetry Foundation's 2017 Lily Fellow.
Yes.
And that means a lot to you.
Yes. I mean, poetry is always my love, you know, and poetry was the way I started writing. It's the way that I've kind of continued to write. And the Poetry Foundation, especially being here in Chicago, is such an amazing place. You know, when you walk in and, like, the library is so wonderful and you can kind of just sit there. And so to be kind of recognized by them is, like, a huge dream of mine, you know, something I've hoped for so long. So I'm really honored.
Well, thank you for coming in and talking with us today. If you guys want to watch Brown Girls, which you should, head to browngirlswebseries.com, and all of the episodes are streaming there.